Well, hello everybody and welcome to yet another episode of One Credit Champ, the show that will eventually all end in tears. Or at least it will when the newest YouTube apocalypse wave hits me. Hey-o! Pledge to my Patreon, everybody. No, seriously. What are we playing today? And today's game is Rampage, so let's put the credit in, start, go, all that jazz. Extra, read all about it, unusual food additive may be recalled. That might be a good idea. This is Rampage, made in 1986 by Ballymib, where you take control of one of three humans who have become giant monsters. George the Gorilla, Lizzie the Lizard, or Ralph the Wolf. All of whom were mutated via various accidents associated with a company called Scum Labs. And now, you're on an insane 128-day tour through the United States and Canada, destroying everything in your path. Because Scum Labs are dicks. And to be honest, if you're that fucking size, why the hell not? Day 2! As you've probably been able to tell, you must face volleys of gunfire and dynamite attacks by the National Guard while you're on your rampage. Most of it isn't avoidable unless you're carrying a civilian, which stops them shooting. But then you can't attack anything, which I'm sure is a great tactic if you're playing with three people. But as I'm playing with myself, I mean by myself, I'm destined for defeat eventually. This game is a right old coin gobbler and no mistake. Now, Rampage got a metric fuck ton of home ports back in the day, 8-bit and 16-bit home computer versions, courtesy of Activision, Master System version, NES version, Atari 2600, what the hell, 7800, and Lynx. The Lynx version even adding the fourth character, Larry the Lab Rat, which nobody ever wanted to play as. I mean, fuck off, Larry the Lab Rat, please. Obviously, later on, with many other Midway games and all the old Atari game stuff that Midway swallowed, Rampage appeared on their arcade treasures collections, too. So, hey, were there any sequels, Mentus? I hear you cry. Oh, yeah, there were sequels, alright. Rampage was followed by Rampage World Tour, which wasn't very good. The confusingly named Rampage 2 Universal Tour. Shit. Rampage Through Time. Shit. Rampage Puzzle Attack. Shit. And finally, Rampage Total Destruction, which was really, really great. Only joking, it was shit. Yep, outside of its first outing, the Rampage franchise has not set the world on fire. Or reduced it to rubble. But worry ye not, Rampage fans, because Warner Brothers bought the rights to all of Midway's IP a few years back, and because movie studios really love to copy other movie studios, Warner have decided to compete, and I say that in inverted commas, with Godzilla and Kong. They're bringing Rampage to the big screen. That's right, Rampage the movie starring Dwayne The Rock Johnson, who appears to be signing on the dotted line for any old shit right now. I can only assume he's padding out his retirement fund or has a fuckload of big bills to pay. And if plot leaks are anything to go by, this movie sounds like absolute bollocks. Oh dear. I've been hit too many times and I'm turning back into a little man. A nude little man, covering his modesty as he walks off screen. Bless his little cotton socks, or lack of them, as the case clearly is. So yeah, Rampage the movie, eh? Outside of the three monsters apparently resembling the originals in some way, they're going to be mutated animals in this film. I guess Warner wanted that Ninja Turtles money too. The Rock's been bigging up the whole project on Instagram, but considering he's the same guy who sold an elbow drop as the most electrifying move in sports entertainment, excuse me if I consider everything that comes out of his mouth to be hyperbole. Until next time, huss!